Okay, I'm standing here at the entrance to Red Canyon, the western edge of the Paunsaugunt Plateau. The more famous landmarks you might be familiar with is this is the western, near the western entrance to Bryce Canyon National Park. Highway 12 is down there in the foreground. That's the main highway, real scenic road that people take as they head into the Bryce Canyon area. You can see this elevated plateau up here to the left or to the east. I'm looking south here. And this is a great spot to talk about a really unique structure in this part of southern Utah. Really, one of, like, there's actually several of these, so I guess it's not that unique, but it's really well displayed here. So you can see in this direction, on the left side, we have these pinkish rocks, the rocks that really make Bryce Canyon so notable and such a noteworthy feature or location. And then to the right, in this really tree-covered area here, you can see the rocks are really dark. And I'll show you these rocks up close here in a second. They're actually right behind me as well. I'll go ahead and show them now, and then we'll walk up to them and look at them a little bit. But you can see the same thing as we look to the north here, these kind of pinkish rocks. We'll talk about those. And then these dark rocks here. What we have here then is two different rock types in contact with each other. And this is a type of fault. So a lot of times when you see rocks of very different types and a very sharp boundary between them, especially at this sort of angle, it lets us know there's a fault there. This type of fault is what's called a normal fault. So in this case, the left side or the east side has been pushed up. So these rocks have been pushed up to form this elevated plateau, the Paunsaugunt Plateau. That's the high elevation area that houses Bryce Canyon National Park, around 8 to almost 9,000 feet in elevation. And on the west side of the fault, we actually have lava flows, basalts. We'll look at those here in a second, that are much, much younger. So this is one of the major features that runs through this area. This fault system runs from southern Utah all the way into the Grand Canyon region. Down there, it's called the Toroweep Fault. And here in this part of Utah, it's called the Sevier Fault. Not Sevier, the typical use of the word, but S-E-V-I-E-R, named after the lake and the river. We have the Sevier River, which is down here, and that drains out into a basin south of the Great Salt Lake, a big puddle of water, basically now called the Sevier Lake. So we're gonna look at these rocks in a little bit of detail, but these are the rocks that really make Bryce Canyon such a scenic location in one of our iconic national parks here in southern Utah. But a good view here of the Sevier Fault, and then again, a nice view here to the north. Just look at how sharp that contact is between these rocks here, these older pink rocks, these sedimentary rocks, and these lava flows over here. These basaltic lava flows are about 500,000 years old, about 500,000 years. And these pinkish rocks here are from the Eocene. And we'll want to look at these in a little bit of detail. These pinkish rocks are mainly limestone. There's some sand and some mud mixed in with it. And most limestones form in the ocean when little exoskeletons, little critters, little microscopic organisms, their exoskeletons rain down to the seafloor and accumulate. It has a lot of calcium carbonate in it, and that's what makes limestone. This limestone is a little bit different because it's not a marine deposit. It's actually from a freshwater lake. So during the Eocene, about 50 million years ago, this section of southern Utah was the site of a large freshwater lake. And I have a little map here to kind of show this a little bit. So here's a paleogeographic map of the western U.S. during that time. I'm going to set this down so I can point out some features here. But you can see Utah here in the boundary. So this is what Western North America would have looked like about 50 million years ago. And I don't want to get into all the details of all the cool features here, but the main feature here is this lake here. This is the lake that the freshwater limestone was deposited in. There was two other lakes, one in eastern Utah and one in southwestern Wyoming, that have really exquisite fish fossils and other types of fossils. This is the Green River Formation over here. But this here is the depositional environment, or the lake that formed these rocks here, the Clarion Formation, these beautiful pinkish rocks that make these really remarkable cliffs and hoodoos. These rocks have been fractured, and with the weather they get in this area with freeze-thaw cycles, that's what kind of gives it these little hoodoos. You can see a little spire over here, these fins of rock, some things along the ridgeline there, and that's what kind of makes Bryce Canyon so special. So we're gonna walk over to the contact with the fault, and then look a little bit at the Clairon formation and these pinkish rocks that make up southern, or this part of the area near Red Canyon. So again, Red Canyon, Clairon formation over here, and then these dark basalts, and you can really see just how dramatic the contact is. It kind of runs down this gully I came up. So literally all the rocks over there are these dark lava flows, and then over here on this side you have mostly the pinkish sedimentary rock. So we'll go down here. Again, the Clairon formation is mostly limestone, some muds, but occasionally there were, the lake probably fluctuated a little bit up and down, and occasionally there were streams and rivers feeding into the lake. They periodically would have maybe large flooding events, and you can actually see an exquisite example of that right here. You can see, if I can get over there, okay, a little tricky with the footing, these gravels, these nice smooth river rocks, these cobbles in this conglomerate. And what's really great here is if we kind of trace this thing to the north, you can actually see it all pinched down. Like here it's only maybe a foot or so in width, and it pinches down to one specific spot right there. And if we turn around and go back the other way, we can see how quickly that unit widens out. So this is a channel deposit. This is the actual riverbed channel, and the margin of the edge of the river, and as you go that way, just widens out. Presumably, if we could get around the corner, I could try looking in here in a minute, we could see the other end where it pinches back out again. So we're seeing essentially partially the entire width of that channel deposited in the lake at that time. Sorry, the footing here's a little tricky. Let's see, anything else here? Another big contact, and you actually can see up here, it's mostly gravels. Then there's kind of a mixture of sand and gravel in this region here. Probably again, some sort of flooding event, but not carrying as large a particles as what I'm seeing up in this gray unit up here. And then as we drop down below that, you see it's mainly just muds and sand-sized particles. We lose some of the big gravels that we see up in this zone here. So different rock types in the Clairon formation, and that's what gives the hoodoos at Bryce Canyon this kind of ridged appearance. You can see there's certain layers out there that stick out, that are harder and more resistant. Other layers that are softer, usually those are the mud layers that are more recessed. They kind of go back a little bit. And then we'll just kind of finish up, walk out on this point and see what we can see. Get past this little spot here. And yeah, so looking back up at that channel deposit, it's actually capping this little hoodoo here. And it looks like it's a little bit thinner, but then it's kind of eroded away. So we really can't solve the mystery of, you know, if that actually pinches out in that direction, or at least kind of document that. But really great scenery here. Red Canyon, just west of Bryce Canyon National Park. Same rocks, a lot of the same scenery that you see in this part of southern Utah. Enjoy.